بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful.
طه ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى تنزيلا ممن خلق الأرض والسماوات العلى الرحمن على العرش استوى له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى وإن تجهر بالقول فإنه يعلم السر وأخفى الله لا إله إلا هو له الأسماء الحسنى.
Taha, it was mentioned before in the chapter of Al-Baqarah about the letters at the beginning of the chapters. We did not reveal the Quran to you to make your life hard or tough, but only as a warning and reminder for those whom fear Allah, it being a revelation from Allah, whom created the earth and high heavens, the most gracious, whom has firmly positioned himself on the throne in a way that fits his honor and majesty. To him belongs what is in the heavens and the earth, and all in between them. He has power, ownership, and the control and knowledge of what is under the soil. O Prophet, Allah knows if you speak loud or if you keep it secretly, because he knows all secrets and what is even more hidden. He is Allah. There is no other to be worshipped but Him alone. All the most beautiful attributes belong to Him.
وَهَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى إِذْ رَآ نَارًا فَقَالَ لِأَهْلِهِمْ كُثُوا إِنِّي آنَسْتُ نَارًا لعلي آتيكم منها بقبس أو أجد على النار هدى فلما أتاها نودي يا موسى إني أنا ربك فاخلع نعليك إنك بالوادي المقدس طوى وأنا اخترتك فاستمع لما يوحى إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري إن الساعة آتية أكاد أخفيها لتجزى كل نفس بما تسعى فلا يصدنك عنها من لا يؤمن بها واتبع هواه فتردى.
O Prophet, did you get the news about Prophet Moses? When he said to his family, I saw a fire and stay here. I may get you part of it or by it. I find some guidance. So when he came near to the fire, he was called by name. O Moses, indeed, I am your Lord, Allah. Take off your shoes. You are now in the sacred valley of Tuwa. I have chosen you for prophethood, so listen to what will be revealed to you. Indeed, I am Allah. There is no deity except but me, so worship me and establish prayer for my remembrance. Indeed, the hour, day of resurrection is coming. I am about to unveil it, so every person will receive in accordance with his acts, whether good or bad. So do not let the person who does not believe in it take you away, because this person only follows his low desires. Otherwise, you will perish.
وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى قَالَ هِيَ عَصَايَ أَتَوَكَّأُ عَلَيْهَا وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَى غَنَمِي ولي فيها مآرب أخرى قال ألقها يا موسى فألقاها فإذا هي حية تسعى قال خذها ولا تخف سنعيدها سيرتها الأولى واضمم يدك إلى جناحك تخرج بيضاء من غير سوء آية أخرى لنريك من آياتنا الكبرى اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى قال رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي هارون أخي أشدد به أزري وأشركه في أمري كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا إنك كنت بنا بصيرا قال قد أوتيت سؤلك يا موسى.
What is it in your right hand, O Moses? Moses answered, It is my staff. I lean on it, and I bring down leaves off trees for my sheep, and I have many other benefits. Allah said, Cast it down, O Moses. So Moses threw it down, and suddenly it turned into a snake, moving swiftly around. Allah said to Moses, Do not be afraid. Hold it back, and it will turn to its original state. Allah said, Press your hand under your armpit. It shall turn white and shiny with no disease, as another sign. Allah said to Moses, We did that to show you some of our great signs. Go to Pharaoh. He indeed exceeded all limits, and tell him to worship Allah, the only God. Moses said, O my Lord, enlighten my chest. Make my task easy for me. Remove the impediments from my tongue, so that they may understand my speech. Grant me a helper from my own family, Aaron, my brother. Increase my strength by him. Associate him in my mission, so we glorify you over and over. Spread your name far and wide. Surely, you are always watchful over us. Allah replied, You have been granted with what you requested, O Moses.
وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى إِذْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى أُمِّكَ مَا يُوحَى أَنِ اقْذِفِيهِ فِي التَّابُوتِ فَاقْذِفِيهِ فِي الْيَمِّ فَلْيُلْقِهِ الْيَمُّ بِالسَّاحِلِ يأخذه عدو لي وعدو له وألقيت عليك محبة مني ولتصنع على عيني إذ تمشي أختك فتقول هل أدلكم على من يكفله فرجعناك إلى أمك كي تقر عينها ولا تحزن وقتلت نفسا فنجيناك من الغم وفتناك فتونا فلبثت سنين في أهل مدين ثم جئت على قدري يا موسى واصطنعتك لنفسي.
We had bestowed our favor on you another time. When we inspired to your mother an important revelation, to place you, Moses, in a chest cradle and cast it into the Nile River. Then the river stream will carry it by the shore, and the person whom will pick it up out of the river is an enemy to me and to him. And I had cast love on you from myself, and that you were brought up before my eyes and under my protection. We bestowed another favor on you when your sister walked along the riverbank following the chest, and she said to those whom picked you up, Shall I guide you to a woman whom can nurse the baby? In this way, we return you back to your mother, so she will not grieve, and her eyes might comfort. And when you killed the Coptic person, and you were afraid of that act, and you were in anguish. We delivered you from that and purified you. And then you went to Midian and stayed with the people there for years. And after all of this, you came, O Moses, to a destined point of time. Note, Allah was the only one watchful over the steps of Moses. I bestowed my blessings on you to perfect you and chose you to myself to go for that order and mission.
اذهب أنت وأخوك بآياتي ولا تنيا في ذكري اذهبا إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقولا له قولا لينا لعله يتذكر أو يخشى قالا ربنا إننا نخاف أن يفرط علينا أو أن يطغى قال لا تخافا إنني معكما أسمع وأرى فأتياه فقولا إنا رسولا ربك فأرسل معنا بني إسرائيل ولا تعذبهم قد جئناك بآية من ربك والسلام على من اتبع الهدى إنا قد أوحي إلينا أن العذاب على من كذب وتولى قال فمن ربكما يا موسى قال ربنا الذي أعطى كل شيء خلقه ثم هدى قال فما بال القرون الأولى قال علمها عند ربي في كتاب لا يضل ربي ولا ينسى الذي جعل لكم الأرض مهدا وسلك لكم فيها سبلا وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرجنا به أزواجا من نبات شتى كلوا وارعوا أنعامكم إن في ذلك لآيات لأولي النهى منها خلقناكم وفيها نعيدكم ومنها نخرجكم تارة أخرى ولقد أريناه آياتنا كلها فكذب وأبى.
Go you and your brother Aaron, deliver my message and the signs that prove my soul worship and power. Never be weak and stay in continuous remembrance of me. Go to the Pharaoh, both of you. He has indeed passed all the limits. So speak to him in a gentle way. Hopefully he pays heed and fears the consequences. They said, Our Lord, we fear that he will hasten against us or will become more rebellious against you. Allah said, Have no fear, as I am surely with you both. I hear your prayers and I see your acts. So go to him, both of you, and say, We are the messengers of your Lord. So let the children of Israel go with us, and do not torture them. We have come to you with clear sign that we are truthful in a message that we are delivering from Allah to you, and peace be upon the one whom follows the guidance. Indeed, it has been revealed to us that the punishment is for the one whom denies and turns away. Pharaoh said to Moses and Aaron, Whom then is the Lord of you two, O Moses? Moses said, Our Lord is the one whom gave each thing its due form and then guided it. Pharaoh said, Then what about the fate of the previous generations? Moses said, The knowledge about those is with my Lord in a book. My Lord neither errs or forgets. Allah has created the earth and many paths through it to make human life easy. He sends down rain so it brings forth with it pairs of different vegetation. O people, eat and pasture your livestock. Indeed, in that are signs for those of intelligence and understanding. From this dust we created you. When you die, we shall put you back in it. Then from this we shall raise you up once again. Note, you will be resurrected again on the day of judgment from your graves. We showed Pharaoh all the signs of our power, but still the Pharaoh went in denial and refusal.
قال أجئتنا لتخرجنا من أرضنا بسحرك يا موسى فلنأتينك بسحر مثله فاجعل بيننا وبينك موعدا لا نخلفه نحن ولا أنت مكانا سوى قال موعدكم يوم الزينة وأن يحشر الناس ضحى فتولى فرعون فجمع كيده ثم أتى قال لهم موسى ويلكم لا تفتروا على الله كذبا فيسحتكم بعذاب وقد خاب من افترى فتنازعوا أمرهم بينهم وأسروا النجوى قالوا إن هذان لساحران يريدان أن يخرجاكم من أرضكم بسحرهما
ويذهبا بطريقتكم المثلى
فأجمعوا كيدكم ثم أتوا صفا وَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْيَوْمَ مَنِ اسْتَعْلَى
The Pharaoh said to Moses, Did you come here to get us out of our land with your magic, O Moses? So we are going to use our magicians against your magic. Let us have a strict appointment in a fair place, not to be backed out, neither by us nor by you. Moses said, Your appointment is the festival day. Let the people be gathered when the sun is raised high. So Pharaoh left in arrogance and put his plot together. And then he came at the appointed time and place. Moses said to them, Be warned, do not forge lies against Allah, or he shall destroy you with some disasters and torture. And whomever forges a lie against Allah will be a loser and will never be successful. Then Pharaoh and the magicians began talking to each other, whispering, disputing among themselves in their matter. The magicians said, Moses and Aaron are magicians, whom seek to drive you out of your land and erase your great system of magic. The magicians said to each other, Better unify your work today in a strong act of magic that will supersede Moses's magic. Successful today is the one whom prevails.
قالوا يا موسى إما أن تلقي وإما أن نكون أول من ألقى قال بل ألقوا فإذا حبالهم وعصيهم يخيل إليه من سحرهم أنها تسعى فأوجس في نفسه خيفة موسى قلنا لا تخف إنك أنت الأعلى وألق ما في يمينك تلقف ما صنعوا إنما صنعوا كيد ساحر ولا يفلح الساحر حيث أتى فألقي السحرة سجدا فألقي السحرة سجدا قالوا آمنا برب هارون وموسى قال آمنتم له قبل أن آذن لكم إنه لكبيركم الذي علمكم السحر فلأقطعن أيديكم وأرجلكم من خلاف ولأصلبنكم في جذوع النخل ولتعلمن أينا أشد عذابا وأبقى. قالوا لن نؤثرك على ما جاءنا من البينات والذي فطرنا، فاقض ما أنت قاض، إنما تقضي هذه الحياة الدنيا. إنا آمنا بربنا ليغفر لنا خطايانا وما أكرهتنا عليه من السحر، والله خير وأبقى. إنه من يأت ربه مجرما فإن له جهنم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، ومن يأته مؤمنا قد عمل الصالحات فأولئك لهم الدرجات العلى. جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها، وذلك جزاء من تزكى.
The magician said to Moses, "Either you present what you have, or we will do." Moses said to them, "You do first." When they threw their ropes and sticks, suddenly appeared to them, due to their magic, as if they snakes turning around. So Moses concealed some fear in his heart. Allah said to Moses, "Do not be afraid. Indeed, it is you whom will be in the uppermost." Allah said, "Throw the staff in your right hand. It will turn into a snake that will swallow all of their artifices, because all what they did is an act of sorcery. And the magician will never be succeed anywhere and wherever he comes from." So the magicians, after seeing that, they fell down and prostrated, saying, "We have now believed in the Lord of Aaron and Moses." Pharaoh said to the magicians, "How dare you believe in him, Moses, before my permission? Moses must be your chief whom taught you magic. I will punish you severely, as to order cutting your legs and arms in opposite way, one right leg, one left arm, then crucify you on the trunks of the palm tree, and you will know which of us can cause more severe and a more lasting punishment." The magicians told the Pharaoh, "We will never prefer you over the clear signs that have come to us, and over him whom has created us. So decide whatever you have to decide. You will decide only for this worldly life, and this torture will end with the end of our life." The magician said, "We surely believe in our Lord, Allah, and his messenger Moses, and we ask him to forgive us for practicing magic in the past that we were ordered to do by the Pharaoh, and Allah is the best supporter and the most everlasting. Surely it is whom disbelieve in Allah whom will be in the hellfire, to never die to get rid of its torture, nor live a peaceful life. The believers, whom are righteous, will receive exalted high ranks, gardens of eternity, beneath which rivers flow. There they will abide forever. This is the reward for righteous, pure people whom worship Allah alone and guard against evil."
وَلَقَدْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَسْرِ بِعِبَادِي فَاضْرِبْ لَهُمْ طَرِيقًا فِي الْبَحْرِ يَبَسًا لَا تَخَافُ دَرَكًا وَلَا تَخْشَىٰ. فَأَتْبَعَهُمْ فِرْعَوْنُ بِجُنُودِهِ فَغَشِيَهُمْ مِنَ الْيَمِّ مَا غَشِيَهُمْ، وأضل فرعون قومه وما هدى. يا بني إسرائيل قد أنجيناكم من عدوكم وواعدناكم جانب الطور الأيمن ونزلنا عليكم المن والسلوى كلوا من طيبات ما رزقناكم ولا تطغوا فيه فيحل عليكم غضبي ومن يحلل عليه غضبي فقد هوى وإني لغفار لمن تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا ثم اهتدى.
We revealed to Moses and gave him the knowledge, saying, Set out with my servant at night, then make for them a dry path across the sea with the strike of your staff, and do not be afraid of Pharaoh or his soldiers. They will never win over you, and you will not be drawn. So the Pharaoh and his troops followed Moses and the children of Israel through that path. But the strong wave of the sea came over them and drowned and overwhelmed them. Allah saved Moses and the children of Israel. Surely, Pharaoh held his people astray and did not show them the right path. He caused them to perish with his arrogance and disobedience. O children of Israel, we delivered you from your enemy and made a covenant with you on the right blessed side of the Mount Tur, Sinai. And we sent down on you sweet manna and quails to eat from in the desert. So eat from the blessed food we have provided for you, and do not exceed your limits or oppress one another. Otherwise, my wrath shall descend on you. The one upon whom my wrath descends indeed falls into destruction, and he will be lost. I am the most forgiving, for he whom repents, believes, acts righteously, is obedient, and follows the right path.
وما أعجلك عن قومك يا موسى قال هم أولئي على أثري وعجلت إليك ربي لترضى قال فإنا قد فتنا قومك من بعدك وأضلهم السامري فرجع موسى إلى قومه غضبان أسفا قال يا قوم ألم يعدكم ربكم وعدا حسنا أفطال عليكم العهد أم أردتم أن يحل عليكم غضب من ربكم فأخلفتم موعدي قالوا ما أخلفنا موعدك بملكنا ولكننا حملنا أوزارا من زينة القوم فقذفناها فكذلك ألقى السامري.
Allah asked Moses, What made you hurry and leave your people behind you, O Moses? Moses said, They are close to me, and I have hurried to you, that you may be pleased with me. Allah said to Moses, We have tested your people after you left them, and the Samari has misguided them, and they worship the calf in your absence. So Moses returned to his people, sad and angry, saying, O my people, did your Lord Allah not make a bonding promise? Did the promised time, 40 nights, seem too long for you? Rather, you chose to do acts that will anger Allah, and you broke your promise to me, and worship the calf? They said, We have not intended to break the promise, but we were loaded with the jewelry from the Egyptians, so we threw it in the fire that was prepared by the Samari, as he threw in it also what he had.
فأخرج لهم عجلا جسدا له خوار فقالوا هذا إلهكم وإله موسى فنسي أفلا يرون ألا يرجع إليهم قولا ولا يملك لهم ضرا ولا نفعا ولقد قال لهم هارون من قبل يا قوم إنما فتنتم به وإن ربكم الرحمن فاتبعوني وأطيعوا أمري قالوا لن نبرح عليه عاكفين حتى يرجع إلينا موسى قال يا هارون ما منعك إذ رأيتهم ضلوا ألا تتبعني أفعصيت أمري قال يا ابن أم لا تأخذ بلحيتي ولا برأسي إني خشيت أن تقول فرقت بين بني إسرائيل ولم ترقب قولي.
The Samurai has carved a golden calf from the jewelry that emits a sound, and then he said, "This is your God as well as Moses's God." Note. So he gave up the religion of Moses of worshiping Allah alone. Do they not see that this calf cannot answer them? It can neither do them harm nor good? Aaron told them before the return of Moses, O my people, you have only been led astray and tested with this calf to determine who is good and whom is bad. The Most Gracious is your Lord, so follow me and obey my command. The calf worshipper said, We would not leave it, and we will stay with it in devotion until Moses returns to us. Moses told his brother Aaron, What prevented you from following me and punishing them when you saw them going astray? Did you then disobey my orders? Then Moses held his brother's beard and head, pulling him. Aaron said, O son of my mother, do not do that to me. I was afraid if I went after you and left them, that you will accuse me with the disturbance of children of Israel and not following your order of taking good care of them or observing your advice.
قال فما خطبك يا سامري قال بصرت بما لم يبصروا به فقبضت قبضة من أثر الرسول فنبذتها وكذلك سولت لي نفسي قال فاذهب فإن لك في الحياة أن تقول لا مساس وإن لك موعدا لن تخلفه وانظر إلى إلهك الذي ظلت عليه عاكفا لنحرقنه ثم لننسفنه في اليم نسفا إنما إلهكم الله الذي لا إله إلا هو وسع كل شيء علما كذلك نقص عليك من أنباء ما قد سبق وقد آتيناك من لدنا ذكرا من أعرض عنه فإنه يحمل يوم القيامة وزرا خالدين فيه وساء لهم يوم القيامة حملا
Moses turned to the Samurai and told him, What then is your case, O Samurai? The Samurai said, I saw what they did not see. So I picked up a handful of dust from under the hoof of the horse, which was carrying Angel Gabriel when they crossed the sea, and I threw that dust with the jewelry in the fire to shape the golden calf. So it became a test or a trial for them, and that is what my mind led me to do this bad act. Moses told the Samurai, Go, and you will live your life cursed, hated, and you will say to everybody, Do not touch. And you cannot touch anybody, and you will have a day of punishment and torture. Allah will not miss that day, and look to your statue. It will be destroyed and thrown away in the sea. Then Moses turned to his people, saying, Your God is Allah, the only God worthy of worship. He comprehends everything in His knowledge. O Muhammad, this way we relate to you some important news of Moses and Pharaoh, and the days in the past. We have truly granted you the sublime reminder, the Quran. Whomever turns away from this Quran and does not follow its commandments shall bear a heavy burden on the day of judgment. All such people staying therein eternity by bearing this heavy burden of sins and disobedience. How evil for them will be the burden on the doomsday.
يوم ينفخ في الصور ونحشر المجرمين يومئذ زرقا يتخافتون بينهم إن لبثتم إلا عشرا نحن أعلم بما يقولون إذ يقول أمثلهم طريقة إن لبثتم إلا يوما ويسألونك عن الجبال فقل ينسفها ربي نسفا فيذرها قاعا صفصفا لا ترى فيها عوجا ولا أمتا يومئذ يتبعون الداعي لا عوج له وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن خشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمع إلا همسا يومئذ لا تنفع الشفاعة إلا من أذن له الرحمن ورضي له قولا يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون به علما وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما ومن يعمل من الصالحات وهو مؤمن فلا يخاف ظلما ولا هضما وكذلك أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا وصرفنا فيه من الوعيد لعلهم يتقون أو يحدث لهم ذكرا فتعالى الله الملك الحق ولا تعجل بالقرآن من قبل أن يقضى إليك وحيه وقل رب زدني علما.
That day when the angel will blow the trumpet, the second blowing, for resurrection, and the disbelievers will be driven to the hellfire together, while their bodies and eyes are turning blue due to extreme fear of horrible scenes. They will be whispering to each other, saying, "You stayed on earth or in graves just for 10 days or so. We knew what they say." And the most wise among them will say, "No, we stayed on earth only one day." O Prophet, people will ask you, "How about the mountains? What is going to happen to them?" Say, "My Lord will destroy and crush them all and scatter them like dust. So he will leave them as a level, smooth plain. You will not see any curves, elevations, or an uneven place. On that day, people will follow the call of the caller. All will be quiet before the Most Gracious, so you can hear not only low whispering. That day, no intercession will be accepted, except from those the All-Merciful grant permission, to whom Allah was pleased with His word. Allah knows all that is before the people on that day. Also, He knows all that was behind them of their life on earth, and they cannot know His vast knowledge. All the faces of all creatures will be humbled down to the only one, Allah, the creator of the whole universe, the ever alive, the all sustaining, and the loser will be the one whom carried injustice." Note, the one whom disbelieved in Allah, ascribed partners to him, and did deeds of his disobedience. He whom works deeds of righteousness while he is a believer shall not fear, because no oppression shall occur. None of his good deeds will decrease, and none of his bad deeds shall increase. So, we have revealed this Quran in Arabic to show in various ways the rewards of the righteous believers and the punishment of the disbelievers, so that they may fear, or it may produce a lesson for them. Highly exalted above all is Allah, the only God, the only truthful God, the King that supersedes all kings with His majesty, the only one controlling all. So, O Prophet, do not hasten Angel Gabriel in reciting Quran before he finishes and say, My Lord, increase me in knowledge.
وَلَقَدْ عَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ آدَمَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَنَسِيَ وَلَمْ نَجِدْ لَهُ عَزْمًا وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى فَقُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ إِنَّ هَذَا عَدُوٌّ لَكَ وَلِزَوْجِكَ فَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّكُمَا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ فَتَشْقَى إِنَّ لَكَ أَلَّا تَجُوعَ فِيهَا وَلَا تَعْرَى وَأَنَّكَ لَا تَظْمَأُ فِيهَا وَلَا تَضْحَى فوسوس إليه الشيطان قال يا آدم هل أدلك على شجرة الخلد وملك لا يبلى فأكلا منها فبدت لهما سوآتهما وطفقا يخصفان عليهما من ورق الجنة وعصى آدم ربه فغوى ثم اجتباه ربه فتاب عليه وهدى قال اهبطا منها جميعا بعضكم لبعض عدو فإما يأتينكم مني هدى فمن اتبع هداي فلا يضل ولا يشقى ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى قال رب لم حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى وكذلك نجزي من أسرف ولم يؤمن بآيات ربه ولعذاب الآخرة أشد وأبقى.
So we advised Adam before not to eat from the forbidden tree. But Satan whispered to Adam and Eve to eat from it, and Adam forgot our order and ate from it. We did not find in Adam strong will. O Prophet, remember when we said to the angels, prostrate yourselves to Adam. All of them did, but Iblis refused. So we said, O Adam, this is an enemy to you and to your wife. He wanted to get you out of paradise by disobeying me. Then you will be in trouble. In this paradise, you are always provided. So you will never feel hungry and you'll never be naked. You will not be thirsty, nor will you be exposed to sun. But Iblis, Satan, whispered to Adam, saying, Adam, should I guide you to the tree of eternity and to an empire that does not decay? So both of them, Adam and Eve, ate from that tree, and their private parts started to show to them, which they did not acknowledge before. And they were so ashamed and ran to cover it with the tree leaves of paradise. Adam did not follow what his Lord ordered him, and he became miserable. Then his Lord chose him and accepted his repentance and guided him. Allah said to them and Iblis, Get down, all of you. One of you will be an enemy to the other. When guidance comes from me, whomever follows it shall not be lost in this life. Whomever follows it shall not be lost in his life on earth, nor he will be sad in the hereafter. And whomever abandons my remembrance, message, and Quran, he shall have a depressed life. even if he seems to have wealth and an easy life, and on the day of resurrection he will be raised up blind. He will say, "My Lord, why did you raise me blind now, while I was sighted in my life on earth?" Allah will reply to him, "Because our clear signs came to you in your life, but you had ignored them. So now you will be ignored in hellfire as you abandoned our clear messages. That is how we punish the disbeliever who disobeyed me and disbelieved my signs. With punishment in this life, the hereafter's punishment is a lot worse, more lasting, and for eternity."
أَفَلَمْ يَهْدِ لَهُمْ كَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ يَمْشُونَ فِي مَسَاكِنِهِمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي النُّهَى وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ لَكَانَ لِزَامًا وَأَجَلٌ مُسَمَّى فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل غروبها ومن آناء الليل فسبح وأطراف النهار لعلك ترضى ولا تمدن عينيك إلى ما متعنا به أزواجا منهم زهرة الحياة الدنيا لنفتنهم فيه ورزق ربك خير وأبقى وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك والعاقبة للتقوى وقالوا لولا يأتينا بآية من ربه أولم تأتهم بينة ما في الصحف الأولى ولو أنا أهلكناهم بعذاب من قبله لقالوا ربنا لولا أرسلت إلينا رسولا فنتبع آياتك من قبل أن نذل ونخزى قل كل متربص فتربصوا فستعلمون من أصحاب الصراط السوي ومن اهتدى.
Did not it come to their minds that we destroyed many nations before them while they walk and observe the destruction that happened? Indeed, in this there are clear signs and a great advice to the people whom think clearly. But for the promise that was already ordained by your Lord, and the term that was fixed, the inevitable shall happen because they deserve it by their disobedience. So, O Prophet, be patient with what the disbelievers say about you of wrong characters, and glorify me before sunrise and before sunset, and in your prayers at night and during the day. You will be rewarded in a way that pleases you. Do not look to what they own or have as any kind of pleasure in this life. It is temporary, and it is a trial for them. Allah's sustenance is the best reward, and it will last forever. O Prophet, order your family to observe their prayers and be patient with that. It is we whom provides, and the good end in this life and the hereafter is for the pious people. Those whom disbelieve said, "O Prophet, could you bring to us signs to prove you are truthful? Were they not enough signs in this Quran that also was mentioned in the previous books? If we destroyed them before sending a prophet with signs, they would have said, 'Our Lord, why did you not send to us a prophet that we could follow before we get humiliated with your torture and put to disgrace?' So, O Prophet, tell them, all of us wait and see at the end whom will be the winner and whom are the ones who follow the right path and guidance."